Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Top Gear Rally for N64. Okay, I have applied some cheats. So at least now we can see the other two missing tracks. Let's do a mountain first. Also have Peach Ball, but type PS. Okay, this is. Well, maybe I should try manual transmission. Manual transmission. I don't know this track very well, so... What are you slowing down? Are you waiting for me? That's nice of you. And suddenly he goes like a rocket. Vanishes. Ah, you are waiting for me again. Playing cat and mouse here. Time up. What? Let's do time attack. And didn't see the whole track there. I do have a steering wheel, but I doubt that emulators support other than joypads, I mean gamepads, joysticks. Unless you somehow reroute the buttons from the wheel. Whoa, slow down. What happened? Okay. Mm-hmm. this car. So if you put a lower gear, then you can. Okay, then you can do a nice turn like this. Nice sharp turn. Jumping like a kangaroo. Slow down. Track gets its inspiration from Switzerland, Austria, or Italy. Definitely some Alps in the background. Luckily there's no damage. Whoa. Bumpy road. Yeah, these old console games. And even Gran Turismo didn't have any kind of damage model, and I always found that pretty stupid, because that steals all the realism. It's realistic that cars can crash, receive damage. We are going off-road here. Whoa. Where am I? This car is too fast for such a twisty road. Let's do one more lap, then check out the last stage. Remember the first game that had a real damage model. Perhaps it was a Formula 1 Grand Prix 2 that had quite sophisticated damage model, and even other F1 games had some kind of damage that you could lose your tires and lose your front wings, front and rear wing. But I think the arcade racing games, they just thought that having damage enabled would lead to a situation where the players would crash and then need to restart the game or stage, because most casual players tend to crash quite often. And even me, even I am crashing here. I consider myself better than casual player, at least in terms of racing games. So by disabling damage, players don't get frustrated in the game. But of course that doesn't excuse why they couldn't set it to be optional. So those who want to have more realistic game could have damage on. No. Okay, and then the last stage, Strip Mine. I don't remember this track at all. It was so bad. So I never was able to unlock this track. On the other hand, I didn't try enough times. It'd be nice if there was a minimap down there. Up here. Special numbers. Ooh. So this is totally new stage. Something special here. Fighters. Yeah. Okay, let's select this mode. Whoa. This is like F-Zero. I wonder that they didn't put any spectators on the stage, because these are just too impossible to exist in the real world. Or studios. Yes, we know. Let's go this way. Oh my god. What a jump. I feel sad that I never unlocked this track. here. This is a real, really nice track. Can I go this way? Well, maybe. Okay, what's down here? Wrecked car. Okay, I'm going weird way. This is not the place I should be. Going off-road like a idiot. What's this route? Oh, it takes me that left route. Okay. Be very entertaining to play with four players or online with 12 or 20 players. Let's take the detour. They will release these old games in the future and have a multiplayer mode. Okay, that was fun. Thanks for watching. See you next time.